So with us today is Maria Chapla, the chairwoman of Ukrainian Students for Liberty, who last week was in Washington, D.C. at the Conservative Political Action Conference, or CPAC. And we are here to ask her about her experiences in Washington and with the conservative movement in general. Maria, thank you for being here today.
Hello.
So I would like to first ask, what attracts you to the Students for Liberty?
Well, I would start with explaining what the Students for Liberty, Ukrainian Students for Liberty, mm-hmm. which we have here in Ukraine, is a part of a big student movement called Students for Liberty, mm-hmm. which originated in the US and for now gathers the most, I would say, intelligent and bright students all over the world mm-hmm. who are passionate about liberty and are eager to make this world a freer place to live in. And here in Ukraine, we also have a group of people who are willing to make Ukraine a free country. And that's why we also came to CPAC to establish this networking with other students and make as Ukraine as well as other countries freer and better.
So Students for Liberty is a international organization
yes.
that's tied
yes.
to the United States.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. So when did you first join the organization then, you personally?
Well, firstly, I joined as an activist mm-hmm. Last September, and then I joined LC program in May. And for now, I serve as a local coordinator. Apart from being a chairwoman for Ukrainian Students for Liberty, I am a local coordinator for European Students for Liberty, which is a part mm-hmm. of Students mm-hmm. for Liberty International.
Wonderful. So at CPAC, first I ask, It's an American-based organization, so that might already answer my question, but what really made you want to go to D.C. to make your voice heard in D.C.?
Well, I truly believe in the power of non-governmental diplomacy, and I think that if we want to establish better relations between Ukraine and the U.S. and other countries, we have to communicate with our peers who have same ideas and with other people, and I think that when I talk to students from the U.S., it is far more easier to explain mm-hmm. to them what's happening in Ukraine, why Putin is a killer, as we had written on our T-shirts, than if I just communicated with them on Facebook. It's different because you can convey your emotions and you can make them understand why it is important to make relations between our mm-hmm. countries and why Putin is such a threat, not only to Ukraine, but to the world.
Okay, so some of the other people at the conference may disagree with you that Putin is a threat. So did you feel much hostility towards your message at CPAC, or were people more accommodating to what you're saying?
Well, I'd like to start with saying that as far as I know, mm-hmm. since Trump has become president, mm-hmm. the number of people in the Republican Party who supports Putin has grown enormously. And that was kind of felt during CPAC. Mm-hmm. I like to say that CPAC is a very big conference and you can find people of different ideologies. You can find libertarians, as Students for Liberty were presented there as well. Mm-hmm. And you can find very determined conservatives. So it's you can talk with people who share different views and in some way have different values. And that's why CPAC is such an amazing conference, I would say. And regarding Putin, I think there were some people from Russia, I think, and they were trying to provoke us. They were wearing Russian, having Russian flags with them, and they wanted to say, we want the U.S. to have bad relations with Russia. We support President Trump and that. So it was, I would say that reactions were very different. Some people said, oh, we want to get the same t-shirts as you have, and while others were simply saying, no, what you're saying is we don't agree with that.
So especially the young people, the college Republicans, et cetera, what was the general feeling there towards Ukraine?
Well, I think when it comes to young people, mm-hmm. I think most of them support Ukraine. They know a lot mm-hmm. about what's happening in Ukraine, in the east of Ukraine, the situation with Crimea. And I think they believe that Putin is a killer and they support us in our message. So I have experience of communicating mm-hmm. with my peers. So I would say from this point of view that most of them stand with us in that.
So you feel as though there's more comfort with Ukraine
yeah.
than might seem that way through the American news right now.
Yes.
Okay, that's
especially
that's,
among my peers. I can say for other people.
You can only talk about your own experiences, of course, but thank you. Now, how do you communicate with, we'll call them the neutrals? So there's the people who would be hardcore pro-Russia, and there are people who are very much in the pro-Ukraine camp, and you're not going to change their mind so much. But then there's the people in the middle. So how do you talk to those people in the middle who may not have an opinion, maybe half and half? Like, what are the tools you use, communication strategies?
Well, I think the biggest problem is that not many people understand what actually happening in Ukraine right now. They hear some pieces of news from the newspapers and other media, but they don't really get the whole situation itself. And that's why I think some people cannot decide whether they stand for Putin or whether they stand for Ukraine. And I think that the most important thing we as students can do is I think that we have to use our power of persuasion and to say why, and using facts, using other things, and communication, various communication tools, we can. We also started a media campaign, as you might have seen. That's one of the communication tools we are trying to use to say why people have to consider our position and maybe accept it.
So it's all about communication, information, education.
Yes.
Now, my last question for you would then be, what are your hopes for the future in regards to getting this message across? Like, do you see it as being very successful, these campaigns?
Well, yes, I do think that we will be very successful in these campaigns because I'm a part of Students for Liberty, and in my view, it is one of the most successful youth organizations in the world. And I think we have lots of opportunities. We can reach out to many people, to people from almost every country in the world. So, and Students for Liberty stand with Ukraine, they stand against Putin. So with all these communication tools and with all these possibilities Students for Liberty gives us, we can convey this message of Ukraine, why Ukraine has to become a freer country, and how can we as students contribute to that.
And are there any future plans for other conferences, major actions, etc.?
We have many of plans as we are launching our own NGO for now. We are going to launch many educational events. We also were very actively taking part in education campaign in support of scholarship reform. We were advocating for the cut of government spending on education. And in my view, it was a pretty successful campaign. And for now, I think we are going to focus more on some educational events. Maybe it will be kind of School of Liberty, something like that.
We had an entrepreneurial school on your
website. Yeah, we also do have Free Startup Project, which is about young entrepreneurs and startups. So we are going to develop that as well. But we also organize Free Generation Forum, which is one of the biggest conferences in Ukraine because it gathers 500 attendees, which I think is a very big number of people for Ukraine and for freedom-loving people. And also, we are going to have other regional conferences. And what is the most important thing, we are going to reach out to students on campuses so that we can build a truly strong network of freedom-loving students in Ukraine.
Well, it sounds very ambitious, and I wish you the best of luck in this.
Thank you.
Thank you. And once again, we had Maria, the chairwoman of Ukrainian Students for Liberty. And thank you very much for being with us today.